question. Hi, everyone. Thanks for joining the webinar. I would like to give you some insights of our MSc in energy storage. But before doing that, let's have a look to the reason why you should engage and you should join one of our MSc courses at Ulster University. First of all, we have all over 200,000 alumni worldwide, and those in the slide are some of the benefits that you can have if you will join an MSc course at Ulster University. Definitely, we have a wide range of courses that can allow you to change your career and be more competitive in looking for a new employment. All our courses are taught by experts. I would say that the MSc in energy storage is a research-led course, so whatever you will find comes from the findings from our research, and we as a Center for Sustainable Technologies are very strong in the research about energy storage. You will find the supported study environment, and you will be able to get qualifications that are of interest for not only the academy, because you may choose to continue with a PhD, but also for the profession. And we have great links with industry bodies and employers. Someone tried to quantify as much as possible the benefits coming from joining an MSc course. As you can see from the slide, you can have a nearly extra average amount as a postgraduate of £8,000. And if you then consider the lifetime in employment, that is transferred to an amount of money of £266,000. And you are more likely to find a job and also to move faster in your career. On the last column on the right, you will find the sources of the information that have been provided. When it comes to the MSc that we offer, first of all, they are flexible because we have a full-time, part-time, distant learning course. And you can also find short courses, postgraduate certificate, postgraduate diploma, MA and MSc. Now, let's come to our MSc Energy Storage. We are not still accredited by the Energy Institute because the course started in 2019, but we are in the process of accreditation, and that will be very important for you for your future career. If you want to make an application, this is the link, and there is no really a closing date, but the earlier the better. And the course is going to start in January, but we have two starts. We have a January intake and we have a September intake first and then a January intake, as I will show you soon. This is the cost of the course, £6,270. And you can find additional information in our website. There is the possibility to ask for a loan for up to £5,500. And if you you are already one of our postgraduate students, you will get a 10% discount and a 5% discount for upfront payment. Okay, let's start with some topics, some more interesting information about why is it important, why is it interesting to study renewable and energy storage. First of all, renewable is a key climate solution that can contribute to massively reduce the carbon dioxide emission. We need to face the challenges coming from the climate change, and the use of renewable sources is definitely one of the main assets. But when you think about moving our current energy system to a renewable energy system, and there are countries like the UK that have pledged to become net zero by 2050, It means that we will have to deploy an amount of renewables, and not only a higher amount of renewables like biomass that can be controlled, but we have renewables like wind and PV that are intermittent in nature and difficult to predict. So the storage technologies will play a key role. Currently, you can see that the decarbonization starting from the electricity sector, but it is not only the electricity sector. To become net zero, there will be a part that will be offset by activities like carbon capture storage. But on the other hand, we will have to go towards renewables for the transport sector and for the heat sector. And that is going to ask the implementation and the use of a quite high amount of energy storage technologies. Now, is there interest in the market? Is there will be opportunities for you, for your job? Yes, definitely you will find opportunity. This is just a forecasting that comes from the new energy outlook in 2019, when it was predicted that by 2040, the energy storage market will grow to at least $250 billion. So it means that you will not only find a job in Northern Ireland and the UK, but there are quite a lot of opportunities all over the world, because all countries are moving toward a renewable energy system, a low carbon system. If you think about a career in the energy storage sector, upon successful completion of the course, you will be more than employable in energy transmission companies, energy distribution companies. Think about also Sony that looks at the electricity market, consultancies, but also public offices at regional and national level, because they will have to define the policies and they will have to be able to have the expertise to assess and identify the right policies, energy policies to implement. You may also choose to pursue an academic and or research career through a PhD program, and the schools, the Belfast School of Architecture and Built Environment, offers quite a lot of opportunity. And we recently got a project, the Center for Sustainable Technologies, led by our head of school, that provided the possibility to 6 PhD students to get a PhD program in the energy storage technology. Now, looking at the our center, that is the one that is delivering the course, we can say that our teaching is really research-led. There is quite a lot of research, not only in energy storage technologies, but in renewables, energy modeling, and we can transfer you all those information. And when you think about your research problem project, we will try to combine you with one of our current research project. Let's come to the structure of the course to get a bit more understanding of what you are going to study. First of all, we have the possibility to have a full-time or part-time course with 2 intakes, as I mentioned earlier, September 21 or January 2022. You will not only study about the energy storage technology itself, but since one of the ways to increase the percentage of intermittent renewables is coupling different sectors, you will get an understanding of the use of renewable sources and an understanding of the structure of the energy system, structure of the energy policy, the markets and the economics, as you can see from the titles of different modules. Each single module is characterized by 15 credits points. All modules are 100% coursework based assessed, and each assessment, each module will contain no more than 2 assessments. In terms of In terms of attending and successfully completing the module, you can see from the slide that if you don't want to continue the course and you will be able after the first semester to complete all the four modules, you will be able to achieve a postgraduate certificate exit award. If you continue with the second semester, you will be able to access, if you don't want to continue with the dissertation project, a postgraduate diploma exit award. And then after the completion of the research dissertation, you will achieve an MSc award. The research dissertation, different from the modules, is 60 credit points, and you will have all the third semester, starting from, sorry, it's not July, it's the also June, the start of June up to September, you will be able to work on your research dissertation. And what we are generally doing is try to combine, as I mentioned, students to our research projects. This is the same structure, but just to show that in this case, students will enter starting from January. So you're covering the first semester, then you have a break during the summer. In this case, you will attend the second semester starting from September, and then you will do your dissertation the new year. So it is 12 month study, but it will run across 1 year and a half before you will be able to get your MSc award. For the part-time option, there are quite a lot of students that are currently working and maybe are interested in changing their employment, or they want to get extra knowledge to move forward in the company where they are. In this case, you will attend two modules per semester. Four modules the first year, four modules the second year, and then during the third year you will have the opportunity to cover the research dissertation. And always, as happened for the other modules, after the first year you have the possibility to exit with the postgraduate certificate, after the second year postgraduate diploma, and in order to get the MSc award you need to, it will take 3 years because the last year you will work for your research dissertation, but that will allow you at the same time to work and doing our course. Now, last year, due to the COVID, our course was online. Now, the idea of the university, if you listen to the messages from our vice chancellor, is that we are moving towards again a face-to-face teaching. To be clear, what we are doing in our lesson is, I would say, a blended approach, because you have the face-to-face lesson with your module coordinator and and your lecturer, and you will have then the possibility to get some online materials to help you to enhance your learning, and we are using lots of different technologies like Panopto videos, wikis, that will allow you to learn. There is an environment that is called Blackboard environment for the students. Our students, of course, they know very well, and there is also a program support area, but for new students there will be the opportunity to go through in detail to the Blackboard area before the start of the course during the induction. In terms of, okay, this is just an image of our program support area. The pass mark for all the modules is 50%, because we are dealing with an MSc postgraduate course. The progress from semester one to semester two is automatic. You can fail 60 credits, so the all modules of one semester, and then you have the possibility to resit. But if in the whole year you're not able to pass this module and you add additional 30 credits additional and you fail in additional two modules, then you need to repeat the year, and over 90 credits you will fail, and you will be withdrawn by from the course. Okay. those are the pass mark, pass with commendation and distinction for, of course, it is a weighted average of different modules on the basis of the credits of each single module. Okay, the new Belfast campus remains on schedule to open its door from September 2021, but in terms of this course, it will be taught in Jordanstown the first semester if the government rule will allow us. And we will move in the second semester to the new Belfast campus. Now I can see that there is Ben. Hi, thank you for joining the webinar. I am here to answer to your questions. Please feel free to ask any question that you may have. Any question, guys? Ben, any question from your side? I don't know, maybe you need to unmute your microphone. Or if you want to write in the chat the question, I'm happy to answer you. Okay. Okay, I cannot see any question coming. However, guys, you have my contact. I am Dr. Brandoni from the Center for Sustainable Technologies. You will find my contact at the start of the presentation, and I'm happy to answer all your queries. You will find also additional information at the Ulster Postgrad webpage, and we are here to answer you. Remember that there is not a limitation in terms of time to apply, but better to do just before September in order to be informed about the course and be ready when the lesson will start at the end of September. Thank you for joining us, and for any question, please don't hesitate to contact me. Bye.